Hey everyone, thanks for joining us for another one of our box opening videos. Today we're bringing you a M15 core set. This set had some good stuff. The core walkers, we had Court of Calling. There's lots of fun good stuff in here. So let's see what kind of awesome stuff we can pull out of this. Go ahead and get this to the side here. All right. It's been a while since I've opened any kind of any of the core stuff. All right, toss that to the side. And let's go ahead and start our cracking here. Now, per usual, we are going to skip past all of the commons. And we're going to get straight to the good stuff of the uncommons. All right, we have a Boon Weaver Giant, Endless Obedience, Stoke the Flames, that was a good card, and a Grind Clock is our rare. Maybe it's just me, but it feels like these packs open a little easier than newer packs. I don't know. All right, so we got Staff of the Wild Magus, Ancient Silverback, Battle Mastery, and a Siege Dragon as our rare. All right. Okay, I know M15 was a fun set for me. That small window when we had Slivers and Standard, man, it was fun. All right, we got Juggernaut, Gather Courage, Belligerent Sliver, speaking of slivers, and we got an Ingerix Wake and a foil Liliana Vess. All right, well, this box has turned out somewhat good. Got our first mythic of the box, and it is foil. I will go ahead and take that. In fact, you know what? Just out of precautionary sake, we're gonna go ahead and throw her into a perfect fit right meow. That's always fun. All right, let's see what other kind of good stuff we can get out of here. Not a bad way to start a box. All right, we've got a Leeching Sliver, Stab Wound, that was good, great and limited. Might Makes Right, and a Mass Calcify. Open that one backwards, I guess. All right, we've got Back to Nature, Paragon of the New Dawns, Profane Memento, and Aggressive Mining. I still don't know a purpose for that card. Don't know. Maybe someday somebody will figure something out. There might be an EDH deck somewhere that somebody figured something out for it. Yeah, I don't know. All right, we have Sunblade Elf, Jurubai Murklurker. Sure. Another Stab Wound, and we got a Court of Calling. All right, that's not too shabby. Go ahead and put that in the halfway decent pile. I don't think it's worth too much. It's not worth what it was, I know that. It shot up for a while and it's definitely gone back down, but still not a bad pull. All right, we got a Tormod's Crypt, Nightfire Giant, Paragon of Eternal Wilds, and a Spectra Ward. This pack is giving me issues here. Right, we have Feast on the Fallen, Leeching Sliver, Into the Void, and a Phytothian. I think that's how it's pronounced. Not entirely sure. were good stuff. I think that that's another one. The pack was backwards. Oh well. All right, we have Gargoyle Sentinel, Constricting Sliver, Frenzied Goblin, that guy's still played, and a Hushwing Griff. I don't think that's worth any money. It might be a buck or so. I know for a while he was worth something. He was definitely a standard playable card. Alright, we have Paragon of the Fierce Defiance, First Response, Might Makes Right, and a Caves of Koilos. Actually, we'll put that over here. Generally, the lands are worth a little something. Yeah, this is kind of fun. I just haven't looked at any M15, any core cards here actually in a while, so kind of liking this. And Soul Artifact, that's not too shabby. We have a Boonweaver Giant, and a Paragon of New Dawns, and a Hornet's Nest. Oh, that thing was vicious when it was standard. Good stuff there. Remember, never wanted to bolt your own stuff so dang bad. Alright, we have a Blood Host, Cone of Flame, Brawler's Plate, and a Soul of Theros, our first actual mythic for the box. Alright, we have a Shrapnel Blast, Staff of the Sun Magus, Congregate, and a Shivan Reef, and a Foil Diffusion Sliver. I'll take that one too. I think that's probably a few bucks. I know the foil slivers tend to fetch a decent price because of Sliver EDH, which I proudly play. That's odd. Okay, so we go through here, and four cards in, the cards are upside down. Interesting. I don't think I've ever seen that before. We have a Curd Chieftain, Act on Impulse, Caustic Tar, and a Chasm Skulker, and a Foil Divine Favor. Yeah, I think Chasm Skulker's still a couple bucks. We'll put him in the decent pile. Alright, and per usual, if you guys happen to notice that I'm missing out on any cards, calling value or whatnot, please call me out in the comments because, you know, I occasionally do make mistakes. We have Wall of Mulch, Cone of Flame, Devouring Light, and a Yavimaya Coast. I've been kind of pulling off random packs or piles here, so I honestly don't know how far we are through the box. I just know I've got stacks in front of me. Alright, we have a Dauntless River Marshal, Paragon of Gathering Mists, Congregate, and Master of Predicaments. We have Sunblade Elf, Restock, Nissa's Expedition, and our second mythic, a Chandra's Pyromancer. So far, I'm not too disappointed with the box. Nothing, we got a Foil Lily, so I guess that's pretty good, but I got a pretty decent price. Here's more. Look at that. One, two, three cards in, and all of a sudden the cards are upside down. That is so weird. Oh, there's a Radiant Fountain. I don't think it's worth anything anymore, but... All right. We got Staff of the Flame Magus, Jace's Ingenuity, Necrogen Scuttler, Goblin Rabble Master. He's worth a buck or two. one more good goblin and we might see something happen with him. And we get a foil Statute of Denial. Mosey on here with some more of this. I think we're roughly halfway through. I could be wrong though. Doing my best to try to keep this in focus for you guys. Alright, we got a Diffusion Sliver, Warden of the Beyond, Necrogen Scuttler, and a Haunted Plate Mail. Oop, run pile. It's so weird how some of these are upside down. I've never seen that before. Alright, we have Military Intelligence, Staff of the Death Magus, Quickling, and Jalira, Master Polymorphist. There we go. Alright, we have Venom Sliver, Belligerent Sliver, Feral Incarnation, and a Goblin Kaboomist. Good stuff right there. So just curious, when M15 was the standard, what decks were you playing? What was your thing? Like I said, I know that the entire time it was legal, I was playing Slivers. Slivers have always been one of my probably top three or four favorite. So we have Darksteel Citadel, Dissipate, Rogue's Gloves, and Obnixilus Unshackled. I don't know if he's worth anything. Maybe a buck or two. I could be wrong on him. I know the original Obnixilus was ridiculous. I loved playing that guy. And we're back to upside down cards. 3-4 cards in. And oh. Oh, and I got a sneak peek at what we got at the back there. We got a Broodkeeper, Roaring Primadox, Staff of the Mind Magus, Genesis Hydra, and a Rummaging Goblin Foil. No upside down cards, huh? Oh, I love that card. Hot Soup. Good stuff. Staff of the Wild Magus, Jace's Ingenuity, and a Life's Legacy. We have Turn to Frog. That's a fun card. Catshow Kitefins, Sacred Armory, and Aether Spouts. I hated playing against that card. Oh, and then we have a foil Caustic Tar. Excuse me, guys. Sorry. Let's see what we can get next here if I can get out of the damn pack. Alright, we have Ulcerate, Nightfire Giant, Circle of Flame, and Kirkish, Onic Ancient. That's probably not how that's pronounced. I gave it a whirl, though, and that's what matters. Alright, we have Military Intelligence, Staff of the Death Magus, Reclamation Sage, that guy was pretty good, and a second mythic, Perilous Vault. Got a small stack of cards here left here. Alright, we have Meteorite, Heat Ray, X-Thrid, Slyblade, Zax-Thrid, I don't know. That guy. That's what we got. We got a Phyrexian Revoker. I still think that's a probably $2 or so, two maybe $3. Don't know. I could be wrong. Well, the deck is, or the box is definitely petered out from a very strong start. We have a Jani's Pridemate, Geist of the Moors, Wall of Frost, and our, actually no, that was our third, so this is our fourth mythic, Soul of Zendikar. I forget we got that other soul earlier in the box. So we're sitting at four mythics right now, and then five if you include the foil. All right, we have Wall of Essence, Seraph of the Masses, Illusionary Angel, and Stormtide Leviathan. All right, down to our last, we got here six packs. Six packs to go. And I thank you for sticking this video out. I know some of these box openings can be kind of long, so I appreciate those of you that watch to the end. We have a Tormod's Crypt, Back to Nature, Wall of Limbs, and our fifth mythic and second Lily, a Liliana of the Veil. So, all right, yeah, this box is turning out halfway decent. Not entirely sure if I'm going to get the full value out of it, but I don't open these for value. I open them because it's just fun to crack packs. We have Gargoyle Sentinel, Grave Digger, Altec Bloodseeker, and a Resolute Angel, and then a foil Mind Rot. Getting down four, including this pack. All right, we have a Paragon of Fierce Defiance, Staff of the Mind Magus, Feral Incarnation, Crucible of Fire, and a foil Forest. Oh, these packs are giving me a hell of a time. The first ones are easy, and now these, as the box goes on, maybe I'm just getting tired. I don't know. All right, we have Blood Host, the Murk Lurker that I can't pronounce, Sacred Armory, and a Hornet Queen. Oh, she's fun. Getting down. All right, we have a Dauntless River Marshal, Paragon of Eternal Wilds, Quickling, and then Shield of the Avatar. And for our last pack, let's see what kind of good stuff this one has. I sometimes have a lot of luck with that last pack. Let's see if I can do the same here. All right, we have a Venom Sliver, Paragon of the Gathering Mists, Overwhelm, and Preeminent Captain. Okay, so I didn't knock out of the park with the last pack, but we still did pretty good. Whole bunch of cards that I'm not entirely sure are worth anything. Hornet Queen might be worth something. The foil Caustic Tar, maybe. I doubt it though. I don't think Aether Spouse is worth anything anymore. But still, lots of good stuff here. Well, some stuff, better than others. But then as for our stack over here, we got a Hornet Queen. I'm pretty sure she's worth a little bit. We got a Liliana Vess, a Soul of Zendikar, Phyrexian Revoker, I believe is worth something. Perilous Vault. Let me get this straightened up here. Rabble Master, I know is still worth a few bucks. We got a Chandra Pyromaster. Yavimaya Coast. I think Chasm Skulker is still worth something. We got a foiled Diffusion Sliver that I know is worth something. A Shivan Reef, Soul of Theros, Cave of Kilios, Court of Calling, I know is worth something, and then the foil Liliana Vess to top it off. I'm pretty happy with this box. I mean, nothing insanely good, but definitely not bad at all. I said I'm definitely happy. Well, thank you very much for watching. It's greatly appreciated. If you like what you saw, hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, let us know what you thought in the comments, and as always, you can follow us on Facebook and Twitter at ChuckWagonMTG.